The 24 Cubans who arrived by makeshift boat to a lighthouse nearly 7 miles from the coast of Florida thought they had made it. Cubans who reach the U.S. get to stay under a law known as wet foot, dry foot. We thought we were on land. If they say it belongs to the United States, it must be part of the United States, says Liban Concepcion, one of the Cubans to reach the lighthouse. But instead of bringing them to the U.S., the Coast Guard took the Cubans to a cutter, where they waited and waited for 42 days. The issue was whether the lighthouse was really dry land. Aboard the cutter, the four Cubans we talked to say they had to sleep on the ship's deck. They couldn't stand without permission, were given little food, and were threatened constantly by the Coast Guard, the men told CNN in the first interviews they have given. For asking for water, they handcuffed my arms and a foot behind me for a whole day, he says. That isn't humane. I don't think those people were humane.
Growing increasingly desperate, the Cubans asked the Coast Guard for scores from recent football matches, but what they really wanted was paper to write about their alleged mistreatment. Then they put the paper in a water bottle with an inflated plastic glove tied to the top, so their message in a bottle would float.
That message, they said, was their chance to let the world know about their plight. We waited for the boat to get close to the coast, and we threw it, he says. It was our last resort. We are in hell, the letter reads. Please, whoever finds this letter, make this paper arrive to the lawyer of the case, or someone who can help us, please. A fisherman in Florida found the lighthouse Cuban's message in a bottle and did just that. The Coast Guard said in a statement that the migrants were well treated, but promised to investigate their allegations of abuse. The U.S. federal court judge, hearing their case, ruled the lighthouse Cubans did not reach dry land, since even at low tide, the lighthouse stands in the water. But 20 of the migrants would be sent to the U.S. Naval Base in Guantanamo while their case continues to be investigated. The remaining four Cubans told us they were overwhelmed by the ordeal and chose to return here to Puerto Padre, their hometown in Cuba. But one of the men, Walter Marrero, says he doesn't plan on staying long in Cuba. If the opportunity comes up, I would probably do it again, he says. Every other way of leaving here is too difficult. Despite their misfortune, the lighthouse Cubans we spoke to said they haven't given up on their dream of reaching the U.S. Patrick Oppmann, CNN, Puerto Padre, Cuba.